Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 665, and today's topic is the relationship of research students with supervisor. What should be your role to cultivate good relationship and understanding with your postgraduate research supervisor, either it is PhD or MSc? And in previous lecture, I have already discussed about the introduction and how we can start our research project, what are the factors. And today I am going to discuss, which is very important, that is relationship of PhD scholars with their supervisor. And as you know, that when you are doing BSc honors, undergraduate or even postgraduate courses, where lot of research, the lectures are involved in teaching different topics, it means you have interaction with many lecturers. You are nourished by them. It is just like chicken feeding, and you are getting that privilege of discussing different topics. For example, if someone is teaching stereochemistry, you will discuss. Someone is teaching carbohydrate, you will go to that lecturer. Someone is teaching instrumentation, IR, NMR, you will discuss with that lecturer. But once you are coming and joining the research in the lab, you are left alone and you are no more nourished, and you are going to have your mentor and you will be mentee. Means you will be given supervisor by the department, and he will help you to supervise your research work. And here the supervision of your research work doesn't mean success or guarantee of success. For example, once you are preparing for exam, if you have done very well in examination, your grade A and B and passing of examination is guaranteed. But when you are doing research, PhD work, and even if your experimentation is very good, it doesn't guarantee success, because there are a lot of factors. And of course, your relationship with your supervisor is also one of the important role. So once you are coming to join the research lab to start your PhD work, first thing is that the supervisor is expecting from you, and you are expecting from supervisor. Here expectations are there from both sides. But what I have noticed, in most of the cases, the students, they expect much from supervisors. They expect that line by line, supervisors should write their introduction, their discussion, their experimentation. And if supervisors are making any correction, again there is a problem if two times, three times he is rejecting the write-up by the research students. And these are all factors. That's why, to my understanding, I am sharing my experience, that once you are joining the research lab, first you try to understand your supervisor and try to develop very good relationship with your supervisor. So for understanding of your PhD supervisor, first thing is that you have to see his quality of his knowledge, in scientific knowledge, his skill, and then his strength, his scientific approach. All these are positive for a scholar. You should not go and dig his weakness. That is very important for a PhD scholar. You should only see his strength, his quality, and his knowledge. what he is doing in his personal life is none of your concern. Secondly, when you are coming to research lab, you are expected to show the responsibility because no more chicken feeding. Good knowledge of experimental skill, theoretical knowledge, also it counts very much your impression to your supervisor, whether you are lazy going, easy going, you are dull, you don't care attitude, at any time you can come to lab, any time you can leave the lab, that is called the question of discipline. So you have to demonstrate the discipline to get the good impression about you, that no, you are serious and you are very much interested in research work. So these factors are very, very important for new incoming PhD scholar. And once you are joining in the department, you will be having your senior colleagues, those who are doing their PhD work since last 2 years or 3 years. You can get the information, you can collect the information about the surrounding, about the lab. Even your technician will be there, your attendant will be there, and you have to interact with them with very good behavior. And then you will come to your supervisor one-on-one, face-to-face in discussion. Your supervisor sometimes may be very young, or sometimes you may be his first PhD scholar to supervise, and he may not be having that much experience as compared to some other very senior or very experienced supervisor and professors. But if someone is young, you have one advantage. The advantage is that he is energetic, he is not involved in lot of responsibilities, academic responsibilities, administrative responsibilities. So at least he can give lot of time to you in your PhD supervision. And if your supervisor is very senior, he is a professor, maybe dean. So in that circumstances, your expectations should not be much from your supervisor. You have to understand his responsibilities, that he is dean or he is head of department. He has lot of other academic activities, other academic responsibilities. So you should not expect much from your supervisor, and you should only try to approach him whenever it is convenient to him to share the knowledge, to discuss the issue. And then when you are coming every day to lab, you should be ready with your diary that you are going to copy down all the experimentation what you are going to do. And at the end, if you get time, you interact, you meet with your supervisor. I have the experience of variety of different type of PhD scholars. Sometimes they are hot-headed, sometimes they are very gentle, sometimes they are very slow, sometimes they are super fast, very, very fast. So I have got the experience of dealing with different type of PhD students. And we are flexible, the experienced supervisors, they are flexible, they understand. But I have come across such type of students, I used to call them guest artist. Guest artist means, if you are watching a film, someone has appeared for 1 minute or 10 minutes, and after that he will disappear. And maybe after 1 hour or 2 hours, again he will appear for 10 minutes, again he will disappear. That is called guest artist. So don't behave like a guest artist in the lab once you are doing PhD work. So some of the students, I have personal experience, they join the PhD under my supervision and they disappear. Sometimes for 6 months, sometimes for 1 year. And after 1 year, when they are meeting, they are telling different stories. So supervisors are not ready to listen different stories. And it is your behavior and it is your hard work that is going to earn your PhD. Not by any shortcut. It's not examination that you, once you write the exam, it is guaranteed. No, it is not guaranteed. Once you are not disciplined, once you fail to understand your supervisor, once you fail to demonstrate good knowledge, good skill, you have created poor impression, not only to supervisor, to other colleagues also, and that matters. So that's why the supervisor's relation is very, very important. And then what are the different characteristics of the supervisor? You have to understand. And you are not supposed to criticize or to say any word where supervisor is not feeling comfortable in the discussion. Don't try to win the argument. First thing, don't get involved in any type of scientific argument with your supervisor. Even if you are thinking that he is wrong, just be patient and do your work, and when time comes, generally it will be demonstrated. So don't use your offensive language. Don't demonstrate that. Sometimes some of the young PhD students, then it is their actually limited knowledge. They think that they know everything and they are very smart. And if suppose supervisor is very gentle or humble, and he's gentle and humble, they think that it is his weakness. No, don't undermine your supervisor's relation. And your supervisor's relation should be long lasting for your whole life. Example, my lot of PhD students after the completion of their doctorate degree is still there, even 10 years, 15 years, 20 years ago, they completed their PhD. They are in America, they are in London, they are in other part of Nigeria. Still they communicate with me. And still they request sometime a reference letter, testimonial, and some advice. So your relation is for whole life. It is not only that just for 3 years you are in the lab or 4 years, and after that, once your PhD certificate is signed by supervisor, it is awarded, door is closed. No. The relationship of your supervisor and your self should be for whole life. And in this case, supervisor is not going to benefit. You are going to benefit from his relation. So this is my very sincere advice to all the PhD scholars. So what I discussed, just I have written here, and that is number one. Supervisor is deputed by the department. Department will allot the supervisor. It is not the choice of the student or PhD scholars. It is the administrative decision of the department, PG board and faculty board to approve the supervisor to guide the PhD or MSc students from beginning to end. The supervisor is an asset to student, as supervisor will be spending time on your research proposal. So actually we should take supervisor as asset, is a blessing, rather than competing him and showing the poor behavior. He is real asset to you because he is going to share his experience, lot of experience with you to defend your proposal. So the supervisor will be role model for scientific skill because supervisor has the long professional experience. That's why you need supervisor, because he has long experience of doing research, supervising the PhD students, and that benefit you are going to get from him. And number two, supervision and mentoring is a relationship, is a very clear relationship, whether it is supervision or mentoring. It goes by relationship between more experienced person, that is your supervisor, and less or least experienced person, that is a student, or we can call them mentor and mentee. The relationship of the mentor and mentee has been shown a very important role in the success of PhD and MSc students. That relation is very, very important for your success to get your PhD degree. It is not preparing the examination and writing and getting good grade. It doesn't guarantee success once your relation is bad. It's very difficult. And that's why some students, they are hardworking, they are very good, gentle in behavior, they are sharp, and they complete their PhD work within 3 years' time, within the time framework. And some they take even 4 years, 5 years. And some of them, they have to get the extension from PG board to continue for another 4 or 5 years. It is because of their overall behavior and their, of course, intellectual capability. The relationship may extend beyond academic guidance to a personal relationship, and it may help the student for future career. If suppose you are still maintaining your a relationship with your supervisor, even after 5, 6 or 10 years time, you are going to benefit, not the supervisor. Everywhere you need the reference letter, testimonials, and supervisor, if he is having very good relation, he will not hesitate to write any good reference letter. Number three, when you were undergraduate student, most of the chemistry knowledge you needed to acquire was provided to you by many lecturers. Now you have joined as a research scholar, that is PhD student, and you are suddenly responsible for your own research problem, and the transition from nurtured chemistry student to self-reliant postgraduate student is often very stressful. Actually, when you are doing your degree, and lot of, the lecturers are attending your different topics, you are not that much responsible because different topics are there and you are carefree. But here, once you are joining PhD as a PhD scholar, it is self-reliant. No more nurturing, no more chicken feeding. You have to demonstrate your skill, your knowledge, and your full responsibility towards your research work. And this is the transition from nurturing chemistry student to self-reliant postgraduate scientist, often very stressful. And number four, as a postgraduate research student, you are expected to contribute to the growth of experimental research by personal participation. And for academic research autonomy, most of the PhD students are not prepared, and finally they are lost and they are confused. Actually, once it is coming to your personal, that is your, without any support, you are going to design, experiment and select topic, all these things. It is a big challenge. And many of these students, after doing their masters, they are not prepared for this type of self-reliant and self-responsibility. So it is very much disturbing, and most of the PhD students, once they are depressed, they are disturbed, sometimes in first year, they disappear. They are not able to continue because of such type of stress and strain. And number five, fortunately for the research component and your PhD thesis, you are given very experienced, eminent scholar, and that is your supervisor. So your research experience in the lab will become part of your life and will become part of your attitude even after PhD if you are not working in the lab. That is sure. This is my experience. And number six, supervisors like PhD students are not alike. Differences in the nature, temperament, and personality contribute to each supervisor unique. Actually, students and supervisor both, they cannot be same. Supervisor cannot be same, and at the same time, PhD scholar cannot be same. Their temperament, their behavior, their attitude, their personality will differ. So here we have to reach to some compromising understanding. We have to show flexibility and more from student side. It is very important to students' advantage to understand the personality of supervisor and his behavior. So to understand the personality of supervisor and his behavior, it is advantage to student. To understand the student is not the advantage to supervisor. So it is the PhD scholar, postgraduate scholars, they should try to understand the personality, the behavior, the characteristics, all these of their supervisors and to their benefit, to their privilege. And the students achieve the target goal of the completion of research work without any conflict with supervisor. So once they understand very well, so the chance of conflict, and if I say conflict means delaying, if your supervisor is not very happy, I have seen it myself in my department. Some of our PhD scholars, their thesis was delayed by the supervisors for 2-3 years because the supervisor was not happy with the student's behavior. So it is to your advantage. If you want to complete your PhD thesis and let it be awarded, he is going to certify that this work is original and done by Mr. XYZ, and here I herewith certify. So there is no reason that you should get indulged in any type of conflict with your supervisor. And number 7, your supervisor or may have lot of quality. You go by his strength, avoid his weakness. Sometimes the students, once they join, they discuss the supervisor's personal affair, his personality, his social behavior, his political behavior, departmental or faculty level. No, it's not your work. You go by his scientific skill. You go by his strength, not by his weakness. What is his strength? What is his experience? What is his skill? What is his knowledge? Appreciate that and go by that. Don't dig his weakness. That is very, very harmful as a PhD scholar. Weakness. Also, keep low expectation and don't expect more in terms of time sharing with supervisor. Sometimes the student, they blame that my supervisor is very busy. He may be head. He might be having some lot of academic or administrative responsibilities. So it is not possible for him to share lot of time with you. You have to get and see when your supervisor is free, he's not under his stress. Then you discuss and don't expect much from him. That line by line, he will write, and just like chicken feeding, no, you are PhD scholar. You should have the skill to express and to write yourself. He can only make the correction. He can only guide you that, okay, now you can go and take this step for experimentation. Page by page, you should not expect that he will spend his whole time for your research supervision. So don't expect much time from your supervisor. Number 8, every supervisor appreciates a research student who is respectful, with very mild behavior, motivated, dedicated, strict to time and schedules, overall discipline. Every supervisor likes a student who is disciplined, who is motivated, who is good who is very good in behavior. But of course, we cannot get all the quality. The students as well as supervisors. So here we have to compromise. And scholarly knowledge. As a student, you must avoid conflict. I am always giving emphasis on conflict. Must avoid conflict. Must avoid argument. Must avoid winning the argument, even if it is scientific or professional argument. And you are knowing that you may be right, but don't get indulged in argument and conflict with your supervisor. He is your mentor. You are his mentee. Maintain this relation. Note, I am giving one note here. And that note is, go ahead, enjoy the research experience. Keep your positive attitude. Enjoy your research work. Whatever in the lab, be cheerful, with light mood, do your experiment, and you are enjoying your work. And get the benefits that a thesis offers. Get the benefit of that thesis, what it is going to offer to you. And even if you never indulge in chemistry research again, the experience what you have got will change your attitude for lifetime. Sometimes after doing your PhD, you may get some political appointment. You may become ambassador, high commissioner, or maybe minister. You are not working in the lab, but your direct experience in the lab will change your attitude. High education, high skill makes men of high status. So, with this, I will stop. Thank you very much for watching the lecture. And in the next lecture, again, I'm going to give more emphasis about supervisor, because supervisor plays very, very important role. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.